Est-ce que je pourrais vous demander de prendre place, s'il vous plaît? On va commencer dans quelques instants. Voilà, merci. Bonjour et bienvenue à tous. Mon nom est Kelly Rice et je suis ravi d'animer l'annonce des lauréats de l'édition 2022 des prix Azrieli du Musique. Good morning, my name is Kelly Rice, and it's such a great pleasure to be hosting this announcement of the 2022 laureates of the Azrieli Music Prizes. And I'm very moved today because it's the first time I'm seeing so many of us in the milieu together. Oh, merci à la Fondation Azrieli de nous mettre ensemble pour la première fois depuis mars 2020, je crois. J'aimerais souligner aussi la présence des représentants de plusieurs institutions musicales ici à Montréal. Analecta, l'Orchestre classique de Montréal, l'Orchestre métropolitain, l'Orchestre symphonique de Montréal, Prodcan Medici TV, la Salle Bourgie, le Concours musical international de Montréal, et d'autres amis des prix. We are grateful as well to those who are tuning in online. Thank you for being with us this morning. 8 years ago, soprano Sharon Azrieli, a passionate supporter of the arts in both Canada and Israel, and a board member of the Azrieli Foundation, conceived of the Azrieli Music Prizes. Since then, AMP has become Canada's largest competition for music composition, open to composers from all nationalities, faiths, backgrounds, and affiliations. Pour cette édition, chacun des lauréats recevra un ensemble de prix d'une valeur totale de plus de 200 000 $. D'abord, un prix en argent de 50 000 $, le concert gala à la Maison symphonique de Montréal avec l'Orchestre métropolitain sous la direction de Yannick Nézet-Séguin, d'autres concerts internationaux et un enregistrement de son œuvre sur l'étiquette montréalaise Analecta. Now, a little history. 2016 was AMP's inaugural year. Prizes were awarded to U.S.-based Polish composer Vlad Mahulitz and to Brian Current from Canada. In 2018, Canadian Kelly Marie Murphy and the Israeli-American Avner Dorman were the winners. Then we get to 2020, and the first Azrieli Commission for Canadian Music was awarded to Keiko DeVoe, who joined composers Yotam Haber and Yitzhak Yadid as that year's winners. All three of the 2020 laureates just had their music premiered in New York City by the fantastic Talia Ensemble. And you may have noticed the wonderful music that was playing as you came into the room this morning. Those were excerpts from the Analecta recordings of the previous prize-winning works. All these compositions have received numerous international accolades. The recordings have been heard around the world, and they continue to be programmed at home and overseas. But today, we're here to celebrate three composers who joined the family of Azrieli Music Prize winners. Nous aurons bientôt le plaisir de rencontrer les lauréats. Mais avant, j'invite Maestro Boris Pratt à nous dire quelques mots au nom du Conseil consultatif des prix Azrieli de musique et du jury du prix Azrieli pour la musique juive, Maestro Boris Pratt.
Thank you, Kelly. Merci, Kelly. And thank you all for joining us here today. The Advisory Council takes its responsibility for guiding the Azrieli Music Prizes very seriously. It's a great honor to be part of shaping a program that has become one of the most important for music composition in Canada and increasingly around the world. As a juror for the Azrieli Music Prizes, I can tell you that my colleagues and I have our work cut out for us. We are aware that not only are we looking for the best possible works that we feel will become part of the concert repertoire, but we're also selecting composers and commissions that will excite the listening public, that will excite you. As a team of composers, conductors, music directors, and musicologists, We bring a full range of perspectives to our adjudications to arrive at our decisions. We are so pleased to have seen great success for our past winners. With each new round, we see an impressive increase in the number of applicants, the countries where they live, and most importantly, the quality of their submissions. Nous sommes tellement fiers et heureux des succès obtenus par nos lauréats des éditions passées. À chaque édition des prix, le nombre des Canada, leur pays d'origine et surtout la qualité de leur travail ne cesse d'augmenter. This year, we received a total of 185 applications for all three prizes. That's over 30% more than we started just 8 years ago. Those applicants came from Armenia, North Macedonia, India, Japan, Western Europe, Scandinavia, Turkey and Greece, Canada, the US, and everywhere in between. I am very proud of my role and those of my colleagues to help the Azrieli Music Prizes champion the discovery, creation, performance, and celebration of excellence in music composition. This year's winners further expressed this goal in very exciting ways. Now I'd like to invite my dear friend and the visionary behind the Azrieli Music Prizes, Dr. Sharon Azrieli, to the podium to tell you more about the prizes and to announce our 2022 laureates. J'aimerais maintenant inviter sur le podium ma chère amie et collègue, la visionnaire à qui nous devons les prix Azrieli de musique. Elle va nous reparler de ces prix et annoncer les lauréats de l'édition 2022. Accueillons Sharon Azrieli.
Merci Boris, merci Kelly. Bonjour et merci à tous et à toutes. I'd just like to also welcome, we're very grateful to have with us this morning, the new Israeli consul, Paul Hirschson, and his daughter Noah, recently arrived from Israel. Thank you so much for being with us. I'm so thrilled to be here today, in person, in this room, as I think we all are. Je suis ravie d'être ici, parmi vous, aujourd'hui, au nom de la Fondation Azrieli, pour annoncer les lauréats de l'édition 2022 des prix Azrieli de la musique. When I thought about these prizes for the Azrieli Foundation, it was with a firm belief that music plays a pivotal role in shaping cultural identity and educating present and future generations. Education is the common thread that runs through all of our thinking and planning at the Azrieli Foundation. Lorsque j'ai conçu ces prix pour la Fondation Azrieli, c'était avec la ferme conviction que la musique jouait un rôle essentiel dans le façonnement d'identité culturelle, dans l'éducation des générations présentes et futures. L'éducation est le fil conducteur dans nos pensées à la Fondation Azrieli. The Foundation's purpose is to open doors to opportunity and a better future for all. We see so much potential in the world, and we believe that everyone, from the most vulnerable to the most exceptional, has a contribution to make. Our Azrieli Music Prize laureates and the music that they create are not only examples of artistic excellence, they are also important storytellers that contribute to our communities by reimagining tales and creating new traditions that will resonate with us all. Nos lauréats AMP et la musique qu'ils créent ne sont pas seulement des exemples d'excellence artistique, ce sont également des conteurs importants qui contribuent à nos communautés et réinventent les histoires en créant de nouvelles traditions. Ils résonnent avec nous tous. On October 20th, 2022, when we listened to what are sure to be outstanding compositions from our new laureates, I know that we will be inspired, educated, and thrilled by the music. And now, let's meet our new 2022 laureates. The Azrieli Commission for Jewish Music is awarded to encourage composers to creatively and critically engage with the question, what is Jewish music? La commande Azrieli de la musique juive vise à encourager les compositeurs à approcher de manière créative la question, qu'est-ce que la musique juive? The winner is Iman Habibi. Iman Habibi will write a 20-minute song cycle on the works of 14th century Judeo-Persian poet Shahin Shirazi, sung in Farsi, using a vocal soloist singing in a Persian style. The work will show the close affinity that has historically existed between Persians and Jews, dating back to 6th century BC, based on one of my favorite stories, the biblical story of Purim and Queen Esther. Dr. Habibi's music captivated the jury, who deemed it unique, original, and fascinating. His proposal for a new song cycle exploring Judeo-Persian poetry offers an utterly unique contribution to the repertoire. Bravo. The Azrieli Prize for Jewish Music is awarded to a composer who has written the best undiscovered work, major work, of Jewish music. Le prix Azrieli pour la musique juive est offert à un compositeur ou une compositrice qui a écrit la meilleure nouvelle œuvre inédite de la musique juive. The jury came to a clear decision to offer the 2020 prize to composer Aharon Harlap for his Out of the Depth Have I Cried Unto Thee, O Lord. Canadian-born Israeli composer Aharon Harlap's work is a setting of 5 psalms for soprano and orchestra and moves through an emotional journey, starting from a state of despair and passing on to one of hope and eventually a state of celebration and complete confidence in God's power and strength. In selecting Aharon for the 2022 prize, the jury described the winning work as a beautiful, sophisticated, moving, and sincere piece of music written by a fantastic musician. It is a major work that reflects well on the state of Jewish music. finally, our newer prize, the Azrieli Commission for Canadian Music, is awarded to a Canadian composer to create a new musical work that engages with the complexities of a composing concert music in Canada today. Here, the question is, what is Canadian music? Enfin, notre commande Azrieli de la musique canadienne est attribuée à une compositrice ou un compositeur canadien et a pour objectif de créer une nouvelle œuvre musicale qui répond aux complexités de la composition de la musique de concert dans le Canada d'aujourd'hui. Qu'est-ce que la musique canadienne? The 2022 winner is Rita Ueda. Rita will write a 25-minute double concerto for suona, am I saying it right? Chinese double reed horn, sho, Japanese mouth organ, and orchestra, incorporating bird songs from among the 450-plus different bird species in Canada. This work will use birdsong and a blend of musical traditions to celebrate Canada's constantly shifting multicultural society, but also to reflect on what it means to migrate and settle on this land already rich in its own history. In commenting on her proposal, the jury said, "Rita Ueda brings rigor and care to her music. Her proposal is well-researched and interesting in the ways that it confronts tensions in and between cultures by viewing birdsong through an intercultural lens. It is a well-considered, generous, and integrated idea for expressing the diversity of Canadian society, where all individuals can be valued for what they bring to the whole." Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate our 2022 Azrieli Music Prize laureate. Please stand.
Merci, Sharon. Welcome to our 2022 Azrieli Music Prize laureates. In a moment, I'd like to ask you to come to the stage. We're going to have a conversation a little bit about your music, those two who are here. But before we get into that conversation, I'd like to share a video of our latest Azrieli Prize for Jewish Music winner, Aharon Harlap. Aharon Harlap is one of Israel's most prominent composers and conductors. He was born in Ottawa. He grew up in Winnipeg and began his musical career as a pianist. In 1964, he immigrated to Israel. He went on to become associate professor of conducting and composition at the Jerusalem Academy of Music and Dance. Last year, Harlap received the Life Achievement Award for Jewish Art Compositions. He is closely identified as a composer of vocal and instrumental music based on biblical texts. Performances of his music have taken place throughout the Americas, Europe, Israel, South Africa, Russia, and Thailand.
The composer sits in his room and he writes and he writes and he writes and he can write 1,000 things and it's never performed. Nobody ever heard of him. Nobody knows about it. And it's just like putting it into the closet. And I think it's important for any composer to be recognized that if someone believes in you, then you start to believe in yourself too. reading the application for the Azrieli Prize, a major component should be something that's connected to Jewish music. My father was a cantor in the synagogue, and my mother was a singer of Jewish liturgical music. So I had that in the home all the time, and the connection with the Bible and the Sabbath and everything that's connected to the Jewish way of life. When I came to Israel and began to write music more serious basis, I feel that the Psalms, for instance, not only because I'm a Jew, but the Psalms that give the believer comfort and solace, how this appealed to me and inspired me to write what I have written. I want to thank the judges for believing in me and choosing my music as winning the prize. It gives me confidence and more stimulation to produce more and more because of the recognition. And of course to Sharon and the Azrieli family, and it certainly helps me to continue. And I appreciate it very much.
J'invite maintenant Iman et Rita sur scène, nos lauréats. Hey, thank you. Thank you so much. I'd just like to say a few words about both of you, just to give you a little more background. I'll start with you, Iman. Iman Habibi is a Iranian-Canadian composer and a founding member of the piano duo Piano Pinnacle. Dr. Habibi has received commissions from the Boston and Philadelphia orchestras and has collaborated with the Vancouver and Winnipeg symphonies, as well as many prestigious chamber groups. His awards include multiple wins at the SOCAN Foundation Awards, the 2012 Esoterics Polyphonos Choral Competition, and the 2011 Mayor of Vancouver Award for Emerging Artists in Music, and the 2016 Brehm Prize in Choral Composition. Iman Habibi. And Ritu Ueda is a Canadian composer whose music reflects today's ever-shifting interactions between cultures in flux. We'll get into that in a few minutes. Recent premieres include those by the Vienna Radio and the Budapest Symphony Orchestras, as well as the Amadeus Choir of Toronto and the SYC Ensemble Singers of Singapore. Her numerous awards include top prizes in the 2014 Penderecki International Competition, the 2010 International Mahler Competition, the 2011 Esoterics Polyphonos Choral Competition, and the 2013 Valtidone Competition. And I'm very jealous because she is currently composer in residence of the San Remo Symphony Orchestra in Italy, a great place to go in the wintertime to work with an orchestra. Rita Ueda. So welcome and congratulations to both. And you have such wonderfully interesting experiences in life, and I'd like you to talk a little bit about your backgrounds and how eclectic they are and how you draw on them in your music. Rita, if you wouldn't mind starting.
Well, I grew up in Vancouver, and my family moved to Canada 50 years ago this year. I studied composition first in Japan, then Vancouver, then I went to grad school at the California Institute of the Arts in Los Angeles, and I'm currently based as a PhD candidate at the Durham University in Durham, UK. So I've tried to go everywhere to study with hopefully the best.
And you also had a period of time where you stopped composing and working for a bit for about 10 years. And if you just mention that, because that's such a rich life experience for you.
It didn't feel rich at the time.
No, but
that's true. My mother was ill, and so she needed 24-hour care. So I t- took about 8 years out of my career to take care of her. And before that, I was a sound designer and basically a computer composer. And when I was going to resume my career, I thought, how outrageous would it be if someone like me could have an orchestral career? So I embarked on a career as an orchestral composer.
So that pause allowed you to be here in a way this morning, which is wonderful.
Yes.
Iman, I'd like you to talk again and get your experience, because I understand you only came to Canada, I think, when you were 17 years old.
Yes.
And talk a little bit, if you could, about your background and your arrival here.
Sure. So I was born in Iran in 1985, which happens to be right in the middle of the Iran-Iraq War. And as you can imagine, there weren't a lot of opportunities to study music at that young age. Life was about survival. So I came to music a little bit later than most children do. I moved to Canada when I was 17 years old. And as you can imagine, it's a huge cultural shock coming from Iran to Canada. And then I had most of my music education after that. I studied piano when I was in Iran, and I studied mostly classical music, but I grew up with a lot of Persian traditional music and a lot of nationalistic music, which was very common at the time in Iran. And then I had most of my music education in post-secondary institutions in North America in Western classical music. And so that brings me here.
There are a lot of Montrealers in the room this morning, and we find Vancouver sometimes quite different from our life here. And I'm curious to know, both of you had your formative years, and Vancouver is an important city for you both. I'm wondering how the city of Vancouver and the life and the interactions culturally there may have influenced who you are as composers today. Iman, do you want to?
Sure, yeah. Well, I was in Vancouver at a very critical stage in my life because I was just a new immigrant. So it was a very, very important stepping stone in me. It was a very encouraging community. I had wonderful, wonderful teachers there. And the new music community is very active. So I started as a pianist. I went to University of British Columbia as a piano student and then took every composition class that was available in there. So I was interested in it from the start. And then by the time I was graduating with my bachelor's degree, I already had a commission to write a piano concerto for my first piano concerto. And it was a huge step forward to me going from writing a very short orchestral piece to writing a 20-minute piano concerto that I was going to perform myself. And so having those kinds of opportunities is invaluable. So I think that's the kind of environment that Vancouver provided for me. And I think Vancouver has a very important place in Canada in kind of understanding Canadian music. It's where Maurice Schaeffer was active for a long time. The Soundscape project was born there. There is a lot of music there that is kind of connected with nature. And I think that's something that, it's part of your proposal, of course, but the Canadian music resonates so deeply with that connection with nature.
Rita, I want to get in now to the big question that you were asked to think about musically when you were doing it. What is Canadian music? How did you wrestle with that question when you were applying to this prize, for the Canadian Music Prize, which you won?
The proposal I wrote was just a slice of the bigger question: what is Canadian music? And I'm still grappling with this, and I believe the answer to the question will be constantly shifting, and that's the nature of Canadian society, Canadian culture, and we like it that way, right? And we want it that way.
You had the question of wrestling with the concept of what is Jewish music, and how did you approach that? What were your first instincts, and how did they evolve as you were?
So my answer is very similar to Rita's. I think music is such a fluid concept, and anytime we add an adjective to qualify it, we say Jewish music or Canadian music. I hope that we don't forget that fluidity doesn't go away. It's an ever-evolving, ever-changing concept. So for me, Jewish music, Canadian music, this is music that's deeply rooted in the Jewish culture, in the Canadian culture. It stems from there, but then it can grow into anything from there. And with every attempt we have at creating Jewish music or Canadian music, I think we're changing it a little bit, and that's, at least that's my hope, that we can do that. So that question is something that I'll be asking myself as I'm composing. Every time I go to the desk, I'll be re-examining and rethinking that.
I actually, now that you've set the table a bit for your piece, I'd like to explore a bit more. We'll get to you in a second, Rita, about yours, but take us along your thinking about exactly what you're going to, how you're going to approach your piece that you've already conceived, because you've already, Sharon has mentioned what some of the ideas that have appealed to the jury. If you could just expand on them a bit, because it sounds, going back to the sixth century BC and relationships between Iranians and, or pardon me, Persians and the Jewish community back Absolutely. Then. Could you speak a little more about your piece?
So it's a 20-minute piece for soloists singing in the Persian style and orchestra. And I just want to...
Just stop a second.
Sorry.
I'm curious, what does the Persian style mean? What do you mean by
it? It's this unique style of singing. It's unlike, if you haven't heard it before, it's unlike anything you've ever heard. And I think that's part of my mission with this project is that usually the singers that are singing in that style, they're framed within a particular concert house and a concert style that might be foreign to people that normally go to orchestral concerts, and vice versa. People who listen to that kind of concert, the orchestral concert might be kind of foreign, a foreign environment to them. So to bring a Persian soloist into our $100 million concert houses that we have built in North America and Europe, and to have those two kinds of music come together, I feel that I'm in a unique position of cultural ambassadorship to show that these cultures and these musical styles and different styles of creation that are well-crafted in their own rights, no matter how different they may seem, that they can meet in a great work of art, if I can produce that great work of art. That's my attempt. But yeah, it's a piece for Persian soloists and orchestra on the poetry by Shaheen Shirazi, who's a Persian Jewish poet from 6th century BC. And I just wanted to show the rich cultural heritage that Persians and Jews have shared for millennia. And this is a poet that, although a lot of Persian Jews refer to as Molana, Molana is an attribute given to, the only other poet I know is given to is Rumi, who's, you know, the kind of pinnacle of Persian poetry. Despite that, a lot of his poetry is not published in the Farsi language. A lot of Iranians don't know about him. So to bring this poet to this platform and give it the stage that it deserves, I think that's part of my goal.
Rita, your work, I was so curious to know how, I mean, again, we're talking, you were talking about Persian Persian singing and contemporary orchestral playing, and now you want to introduce a Japanese instrument, a Chinese folk instrument, with a modern symphony orchestra, and you want to put all Canadian bird songs together. Whoa, that's going to be, tell us how you're going to, how you're thinking about threading all that together.
The musical inspiration started with a conversation I had with a sona player, Zhang Xiwu, in Vancouver, and he told me a little bit about how he was trained to play the sona in China, and it's a double reed instrument, much like the European shawm, and he said to me he would be they would bring him a bird, and he would be expected to listen to the bird, to imitate the bird, and that's how he was taught how to play the instrument. So I said to him, and he showed me some of these birds that he could play, and they were Chinese birds, of course, and then so I said, well, you've been living in Canada for 20 years, what do you think? If I brought you Canadian bird songs, you think you could do it? And he said, theoretically, yes, he can. So
chickadee-dee-dee,
right. So then I thought to myself, there is one bird that he cannot play. It is the phoenix, because it's a mythical bird, and there is no sound. But the show is an instrument, theoretically, in the shape of a phoenix, and it represents the country I come from. And so I thought it would be great to have a combination of a Chinese-Canadian player with a Japanese instrument and my own, and combine it with my own Western training as an orchestral composer.
Wow. where are you now in all this? I mean, you've got to put all this together, but where are you in the process? Because there is 20th of October, 2022, there's going to be an orchestra in Montreal playing the piece. Where are you in the creative process or the writing of this?
Well, right now I'm still thinking or rethinking what is Canadian music. In that when I first wrote this application, I thought, well, what I'd like to do is mainly express my gratitude for my parents having the foresight to bring me to Canada, and it's worked out really great for my family. But then all these news reports of children being found underground, surfaced, and then I thought to myself, well, just a simple gratitude celebration is also, I have to think about it. So I am still in the research process, and I'm still in the thinking phase. Still,
I'm quite moved by both of you responding to what as your milieu, as our milieus together evolve, how you're responding to that evolution. As we learn more about Canadian culture, you're talking about in Jewish cultures as well, where as things evolve. Where are you in your process of writing your piece? And have you told Yannick Nezet-Séguin he has to find a Persian singer for next October?
So I'm going to help with finding the Persian singer, but that is the stage I'm at mostly. So it's still the research stage. And unlike writing for instruments, writing for voice, because the voice is such a unique instrument, it's important to find the vocalist you're writing for before you start conceiving of the piece. So I'm very close to kind of finalizing a soloist. So that's the stage I'm at. And then I'll get down to my desk and write the piece.
Thank you both very much. I was wondering if there are any questions. Est-ce qu'il y a des questions ici à nos lauréats sur les œuvres, sur le processus de composition, ce qu'elles ont mangé le soir, quel genre de champagne, quelle marque de champagne qu'ils aiment boire? What kind of champagne you like to drink after you won a big prize like this? Any questions at all from anyone here? No, we're good? Okay. Merci encore pour réflexion ici. Nous aurons le plaisir d'entendre la musique d'Iman Abibi, Aharon Harlep et Rita Ueda au concert gala des prix Azraeli de musique qui aura lieu le 20 octobre 2022. À la Maison Symphonique de Montréal avec l'Orchestre Métropolitain sous la direction de Yannick Nezet-Séguin. So again, for those online, please join us on October 20th, 2022 at the Maison Symphonique in Montreal to hear all three laureates' prize-winning works performed by the Orchestre Métropolitain conducted by Maestro Yannick Nezet-Séguin. Now, before we leave today, we have a wonderful announcement, a very exciting announcement. I'd like to ask Sharon Azraeli to return to the podium to share some exciting news. Madame Azraeli.
Well, you all know my singing career has taken me around the globe. And although we started out today by saying that I've been a philanthropist in Canada and Israel, I hope that my philanthropy extends further than that. In fact, we've tried very much to make these prizes international. And so, to that end, actually, my vision always was that these prizes would be international. I always had a vision that they would be four prizes. And so I am thrilled to share with you the news that starting with our 2024 competition, the Azraeli Foundation will be offering a fourth Azraeli Music Prize, fourth and final. This time, we will be inviting composers worldwide to engage with the richness of humanity's diverse cultural heritage. As you may know, 2024 marks the 10th anniversary of Azrieli Music Prizes and the 10th anniversary of my father, Zichrono Levracha's passing. So it's a very important year. And I can't think of a more inspiring way to celebrate than in launching the Azrieli Commission for International Music. Please stay tuned for more information about this prize. Thank you so much for joining us today. Merci d'être avec nous. And once again, congratulations to our brilliant laureates. Thank you, Kelly. Thank you, Boris. Thank you all.